Welcome back, queens and kings, and thanks for watching. In today's video, we're going to be creating 5 gorgeous Christmas DIY using Dollar Tree products. If you all would like to see how, please continue to watch. Okay, queens and kings, before we jump into the video, I would like to let you guys know this portion of the video is collaborated and sponsored by. As you guys can see, they sent me some gorgeous, gorgeous red roses here in this clear container here, this box. Now, one thing I do like about this box here, besides it being clear and just gorgeous as it can be, it also is a storage. As you guys can see in the bottom there, I have my coasters. So it's a 2-in-1, which is so fabulous, so fabulous. But another great thing about these roses, they last up for 1 year. So you don't have to water them or anything, honey. Just put them out and just let them be and let them be the statement piece for you. So you know the holidays are coming up. So they also gave me a discount code, which I will place it here on the screen as well as leave it in the description box. So therefore, you can purchase them for whoever this year. It don't have to just be for the holidays, honey. It could be for a just because. So anywho, now let's move on to the first DIY here. I'm using a Dollar Tree Christmas box and I'm using some faux garland that I just broke down in pieces that I had around the house or in my stash, and I'm just going to snug that into the box until I get it how exactly that I want. So you're just going to play around with it until you get the look that you want. So now I'm moving on with some velvet roses here. I had these for a minute, but I purchased these from Michael's. I didn't see them this year. They may bring them out, but you know, everyone's still stocking the shelf. So anywho, I'm just gonna glue those in the desired area where I want them to be and just play around it some more.
These are the good times with you, baby. This year it's just gonna be you and me. Hang by the fire and chill.
So I have them how I want them, I think I do. But anywho, I'm going to add this little pick in just to put a little more festa to this box here, which I am so much loving. And then I'm going to take Dollar Tree little ribbon here. I think these have snowflakes on them. And I'm just going to basically glue those on the outside just to make it look like a gift, which is a gift box. And this inspiration was actually inspired by Forever Roses. So once again, click on the link in the description box as well as use the coupon code so therefore you can get a discount. So anywho, I'm just taking the ribbon and cutting down to size and wrapping around like we actually tying up a whole gift. And I'm doing the same thing here for the top. Okay, so for the lid here, I'm just going to place some glue on the inside. Then I'm going to place this stick in there just so I can lean it inside the box so it look like the bouquet is coming out of the box. And just stick it in there. And this is the finished look. Like, I love the way how this turned out. So you also can make this for a gorgeous gift as well, to give it to someone special, someone who's lucky to actually have this. You know, it's the holidays once again. So now moving on to the next, well, I was going to say DIY, but I would say more of a hack, because this one here is just using some Dollar Tree holiday cards in a picture frame that I had around the house, and I'm just going to place that in there. I cleared the glass off best as I could and just stick that card in there, and now you have a cute and easy, simple holiday decor piece. Something just fabulous to sit on your coffee table. Look how beautiful it is sitting there with those flowers. But anyways, moving on to the next DIY here, I just have some scattered gems that I purchased from Hobby Lobby. You know, the little rhinestone placemats, they have them as little scatters. And I'm using a Dollar Tree ornament and using some tacky glue. And I'm basically going to draw or spread the tacky glue on the ornament into whatever design that I like or whatever. And then I'm just going to scatter the jewels or the gems all over the glue.
I'm coming home to you.
Can't wait to hold you. We'll be sitting by the fire and watch our favorite movies on TV. We can do what we wanna do. Walk under the moonlight and kiss under the stars.
All right, queens and kings, so here are my ornaments. And I say my ornaments because I did make two of them, and I love the way that these came out. So basically, I tied some more of that snowflake river from the Dollar Tree on here. And then I have like the little dripping effect design that's going on the ornaments, and I just love the way that these came out. I mean, I love all of these. These are gorgeous. And if you guys don't know, red is going to be one of my colors this year. So anywho, this is another simple DIY here. I'm using some fire red, I think, paint from Walmart. Then this little plaque here came from the Dollar Tree. I had it a while. I spray painted it white, and we used some white letters as well that came from the Walmart. And I'm just going to cover it up with some red, this red paint, which it tucks several coats. So I would do the other coats offline, but this is how it looked. Now here, I was going to paint the whole thing red, but I did like how the white just made it pop a little bit more, made it a little bit more festive. So I'm taking my letters here, and I decided to start off with writing out 25. I was going to use the white letters. Then I was like, no, I need something else to make it stand out and pop. So I'm actually going to get some different letters, which is the gold letters. Well, I meant to say gold letters as well as numbers. So I'm just gonna peel off 25, like I said. This basically just gonna be a simple little sign, little decor piece that I can place on my end tables, wherever I desire to actually place them at. So I'm basically just trying to figure out where I would like to center it. So for the 25, it will be gold, and for the December will be white. And these gold letters came from Walmart.
Is a time to cheer. Let our loved ones, our family and friends have a Christmas with so much love and with joy and laughter.
So I love the way that this turned out, but it just still look a little bit simple. So I decided to just get some piece of the garland stuff and started placing it up to the top. But then I was like, no, I'm going to slant it. So therefore, I'm just going to fill it in and make it a little bit more festive so it don't just look like a old fire truck sign, because that's what it actually gave me the image of.
Lights lighting up this town. And as I walk outside, Christmas choir sing Merry Christmas to you.
Okay, queens and kings, so here is my little tabletop decor, and I love it. Just by putting that little greenery with the little garland up to the top or whatever, it did bring it out more. And then I put a snowflake on there as well. So moving on to the last and final DIY. Now, out of all of them that I have created, I think this was the one that I really liked most. And I'm going to use all these items actually came from the Dollar Tree, even the wood sticks, because they come in a bag. And the bird, I keep forgetting what the bird, Cardinal bird. Oh, yeah, I know what I'm saying. But anyways, I was just going to basically make a snow globe. That's basically what I'm doing here, what I'm trying to do. Well, I think it turned out pretty much. Okay, queens and kings, so first thing first, I'm just going to cut off the wire here that's underneath the bird, and I'm going to glue it onto the log or the tree branch, I would say here, just so therefore it look like the bird is actually sitting on a tree branch once we put it inside the globe, because I think that'll be very cute, you know, just bring a little bit more decor inside. So we're going to place the branch as well as the bird back in there. Now I had to play around with it a little bit because I was like, oh my goodness, what have I done? I don't think I'm gonna get it in there. So now I'm trying to basically get the tail to actually flare up. I'd rather for the have it to flare up, but honey, I couldn't get it to do what it do. So I'm just gonna have to set it how it is. And then I'm gonna take my piece of my greenery to shove it in there as well, so it look a little bit more festive, you know, just give you that look like the bird is actually sitting on a branch. So I love the way that it's looking so far. Now here, I'm just gonna flip it upside down, and I went and got some I can't think of it. You guys know what it is. You put it in your bathtub. Epsom salt. Yes, Epsom salt. Thank you, Queen and King. So I placed that in there so it could be my snow. So therefore, it could give that snow glow look or vibe. So I screw it back on there, shake it up, and look how she's looking so far. And then I'm going to take the extra piece of greenery, and we're going to glue that around it. And I'm going to glue some ribbon around the base of it as well, off camera. And here she is. I love the way this turned out. This one here was just a little bit special to me. I just love the way that it turned out. And if you guys don't know, I am going with the red cardinal bird for 2020. So if you guys would like to see how I style my home using all these home decor items, check out my other channel, which is Queen Val Livin. I will leave it in the description box. And I would like to give a shout out to for actually sending me these gorgeous flowers once again. If you guys don't know, this is my second time actually doing a collaboration with them, if I didn't mention that. But I do have a discount code, so if you guys would like to get your hands on these, because these are the new set that they do have on their website. But I will leave the discount code on the screen as well in the description box. And I would like to say thank you, Queens and Kings, for watching this video. If you all enjoy it, please like, comment, share, and subscribe. And you guys know what to do. Continue to be brilliant. Bye-bye. Love you guys.
No, I'm not the problem. Man, that's on you.